गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द थर्ड चैप्टर फ्रॉम फ्लैमिंगो एंड द टाइटल इज डीप वाटर। एक्चुअली द टाइटल इज यू कैन से मेटाफोरिकल। देयर इज समथिंग व्हिच वी ऑलवेज हैव इन आवर माइंड, अ फियर ऑफ डेथ यू कैन से। द करेक्टर विलियम डगलस, ही वॉज अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड। At that moment, he has got the aversion from water. Aversion means hatred. He went to California beach with his father, and when he was standing on the beach, a wave swept over him, and he thought that he got buried under the earth. But he was saved, and right from that moment, he has got aversion from the water. He never went to California beach, but when he became at the age of, you can say, 8 or 10 years, he again had a desire to go to YMCA pool and start learning swimming. There again he had a very drastic experience, and again whenever he went in the deep water, the fear of water always caught him, freeze his legs, paralyzed him, and he was not even to move, but still he had a desire to learn swimming. How he got it, how he won his fear of water, this is all the story about. So we can say that the author William Douglas talks about his fear of water and how he finally overcame it. So in this he narrates an autobiographical incident, what he experienced, that occurred when he was 10 or 11 years old and almost drowned in the YMCA swimming pool. As a result, he developed a fear of water which he was able to conquer, to win over after several years by just determination. If you have determination to win over something in life, you will definitely. Determination is the only key to come over the difficulties in life. First of all, let us justify the title. Why William Douglas gave his autobiographical the title Deep Water? This extract is appropriately entitled Deep Water. The author recounts his fear of swimming following in an incident in which he had been swept away by a wave. Another incident which further aggravated his fear, made his fear more deep in his heart, was when a boy pushed him into the deep side of the swimming pool and he nearly drowned. He was almost drowned, but slowly he overcame his fear through determination and strong will. He even took the services of an instructor. A swimming instructor, he swam in different pools and lakes to overcome his fear. The title also signifies that the author's fear was a deep-rooted one, deep water, a deep-rooted fear. In short, the title is appropriate. There is a brief summary I'm going to tell you. Deep Water tells us how the writer overcame his fear of water and learned swimming. He had developed a fear of water in childhood when he was 3 or 4 years old. He went to California with his father. One day on the beach, the wave knocked him down and swept over him. He was terrified, but his father laughed as he knew that it was not harmful. The experience bred a permanent fear of water. Another incident, more serious, increased his terror. The writer was trying to learn swimming in the YMCA swimming pool. One day, while he was waiting for other boys to come, a boy of 18 suddenly played a dangerous prank, you can say, and pushed him into the water. The writer was terribly frightened. He went down 9 feet into the water and his lungs were full of the unreleased air. When he reached the bottom, he jumped upward with all his strength. He came up but was very slow. He tried to catch hold of something like rope, ladder, but grasped only at water. He tried to shout, but no sound came out. He went down again. His lungs ached, head throbbed, and he grew dizzy. He was becoming unconscious. He felt paralyzed with fear. Only the movement of his heart told that he was alive. Again he tried to jump up, but this time his limbs would not move at all. He looked for rope, water wings, but all in vain. Then he went down again, the third time. This time all the efforts and fear ceased. He was moving forwards, lying on the side of the pool. When he came to the conscious, he was not able to move. The other boy nearby and the coach remonstrating with him for nearly causing him to drown. As a result of the near-death experience, the terror that he had experienced in the pool never left him. It haunted him for years. It spoiled many of his expeditions of canoeing, swimming, fishing, boating, all that was spoiled. It spoiled his pleasures in Main Lake, New Hampshire, Columbia, and Bumping Lake, etc. But the writer was determined to conquer his fear. He took help of a swimming instructor to learn swimming. The instructor taught him various actions necessary in swimming. He trained Douglas to put his face under water and exhale and inhale, raising it above water. All these are the practices done while swimming. He practiced for several weeks. He had to kick with his legs for a few weeks on the side of the pool. At last, he climbed all these actions and made Douglas a swimmer. He thus learned swimming, but the terror continued. Whenever he was in water, his terror returned, and the author tried to face the new challenges. When the terror came, he confronted it by asking it sarcastically what it could really do to him now. He plunged into the water as if to defy the fear. Once he took courage, the terror vanished. He faced the challenges deliberately in various places like the warm lake. He conquered his fear of water at last and became a perfect swimmer.